Praise the Lord, saints. You are listening to the Open Door Radio broadcast with your host, Pastor Roberto V. Roache, Sr. of the Open Door Missionary Baptist Church, located at 4817 West 3rd Street in the city of Dayton, Ohio, inside of the Progressive Baptist Church building. Our weekly services begin with our hour power at 11:30 a.m. to 12:30 p.m. and worship services begin at 1 p.m. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the spiritual ride. This is Open Door Radio,
Not a second or another minute, not an hour or another day, but at this moment with my arms outstretched, I need you to make a way, as you have done so many times before. Through a window or an open door, I stretch my hands to, come rescue me, I need you right away. I need you now, I need you now, I need you now, I need you now. Another minute, not an hour of another day, but Lord, I need you right away. If I never needed you before to show up and restore all of the faith that I left slip while I was yet searching the world for more, the truest friend I have indeed, you're my best friend I know in need. I stretch my hands to thee, come rescue me, I need you right away. Doing things on my own, the tests and trials that come to make me strong, the feelings of guilt, hurt, shame, and defeat, the ways of trials that beat upon me, but to know, Lord, that not another minute, Lord. Can't wait another day. Oh, oh Lord. Please make a way. Oh, Lord, oh, Lord.
Yeah. Do you need Jesus today? I do. Good morning, good morning, good morning. Coming to you live from the Open Door Missionary Baptist Church, Good morning to all my Father's children. God is truly good, and He is worthy to be praised. I need Jesus today. Do you need Him? By Smokey Norfolk.
This is Open Door Radio, Dayton. If you are looking for a reliable home health care agency and a reliable non-emergency transportation company, the Forever Ready Home Health Care and Transportation Company is at your service. If you are STNA, CNA, or HHA, and are looking for more hours, full-time benefits, and more, Forever Ready is the place you want to be. Call today, 937-999-6130, or apply online, the number 4, EverReadyHHC.com. We are Forever Ready. You are listening to Open Door Radio Dayton with your host, Pastor Roberto V. Roche, Sr.
Saints, we have something very good today to understand about God. Don't hate me because I know Jesus the Christ.
All right.
Do not hate me because I know who Jesus is. Amen? Amen. And so when you look at this, let's talk about this word here first before we go any further to the lesson. Do not hate me because I know Jesus. When you know who Jesus is, you have solidarity. Solidarity. Amen. Now, solidarity means fellowship of responsibilities and interests. Amen. Fellowship of responsibilities and interests. And so, because I know Jesus, I have solidarity with Christ.
Yes.
Now, the Bible says that they hated me, they will hate you also. Amen. And so God is saying, when you know who I am, when you become into the fold, amen, when you come into the fold of God, then they are going to hate you because you know who I am. And so I'm here to let you know that we cannot hate those, amen, that know who Christ is. Amen. But we have people in the world that hate you because of all different types of things. Amen. How many of us have ever hated someone? Amen. We all have been down that road where we disliked someone, we hated someone, or we just didn't want to be around someone. Amen. But the thing is, God is saying, once you become a child of God, amen, once you come into the fold, once you are under the umbrella of safety, we cannot have hatred in our heart anymore for no one. Amen. And so my job is to let people know, do not hate me because I know Jesus. Because one thing I can tell you, that people will hate you because you know God, because you start telling them about scripture. Amen. You start telling them about things that they should not or should not do or what to do. Amen. And so now people want to step back because you know the mighty King.
All right.
Amen. Amen. I remember a song in the 80s or the early 90s. We used to always sing this song, and it was a mixed song. It said, there's some haters in this house, point them out, point them out. There's some haters in this house, amen. And so some of us used to go into clubs, and we would be singing and hearing that song and pointing at people, amen. And knowing that somebody hating you, amen, because you might look good or whatever it may be. But God don't want you to hate people, amen. You should not have that mentality that you hate someone because they are leaning towards the power of God. It does not matter what you do in life, someone will always be jealous of you, but if you trust Christ, He'll see you through it. Amen. He will see you through it, saints. If you trust God, if you trust Jesus, He will see you through anything. No matter what's going on in your life, He will see you through it. Luke is telling the story about John the Baptist. John wants us to be loyal and help those in need. Amen. So we have to be loyal, saints. We have to be able to help those that are in need. How many of you have helped someone every now and then when times get a little hard?
Yes.
Verse 11 said, He answered and said unto them, He that have two coats, let him impart to him that one coat, because he don't have a coat. Amen. And those that don't have meat, let him do likewise. Amen. And so right there, it shows you that God is saying you have to be able to help someone. If you got two coats and you know someone don't have a coat, then give them a coat. Amen. Are you with me today? Amen. If you know someone that is hungry and you got a refrigerator full of food, amen, then it's okay to make them a care package. Amen. Yes. It's okay to put some extra chicken in there or whatever it is and share it with someone else. Amen. 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 I can talk about Mama Shirley. Amen. She's always trying to give. Amen. She gave us some tomatoes. Man, them tomatoes was good. Amen. And so she had some extra tomatoes and asked us, did we want some? Amen. And the thing that was wonderful about it is that the tomatoes was big. Amen. And they also was good. Amen. And so we have to understand that when you have something extra, it's okay. When God bless you, you bless someone else.
Right.
Are you with me?
Yes,
right. You see, we got to understand. So when you find out that what God wants you to do, then you start to impart on those and do those things that God wants you to do. Jesus don't bless us for us to just sit back. Amen. People will hate you because you are being blessed by God. So we can be a help to others in need. Amen. So when God is blessing you, you got to be a help to others. Amen. Amen. So don't hate me because I know who Jesus is.
Amen.
The funny thing about this is Christians is more jealous than sinners.
All right now.
Uh-oh. Christians is more jealous than sinners. Boy, if a Christian think you're getting a little bit more than them, you will have problems out of them. Amen. If they feel that you're being a little bit more blessed than they are, then the other Christians are going to turn their nose up. They're going to look at you. They're going to, why the Lord blessing them? I'm saved too. Amen. But there's no thing. You don't have to. What the funny thing about that, God is saying, stay in your lane. Don't worry about because somebody else is getting blessed. Maybe they're doing something that you're not doing. Maybe they're obeying God and you're not obeying God. Amen. And so the thing is, just because he's blessing someone else, got a car before you did. Someone else's home looks better than you. You can't get jealous of them because God is blessed. What you got to do is work on your relationship with God.
Amen.
Can you hear me today, saints? Amen. Amen. I don't know if this mic turned up or not. Amen. But I'm here to let you know that God is looking for us not to be jealous of each other. Amen. We have to be able to work with each other and understand who God is. You know, my friends, visitors, and Christians fellowship. Amen. Today, I encourage you not to worry about jealous saints.
Amen.
Don't worry about those that's jealous of you. Amen. Don't worry about those that's jealous of you. Don't, you know, they don't hate you. They hate what God is doing with you.
All right.
Amen. See, that's why I say, don't be mad at me because I know who Jesus is. So what you got to understand is they not mad at you. They mad at Jesus. I hope you hear me today.
Yes.
Amen. You see, don't be jealous because I know Jesus. Yes, I can say today that I know Jesus and you can know him too. Amen. He made it easy for you and for me. You see, John's teaching and knowledge about Christ was amazing. So the people wondered, was he the Christ or not? Amen. So saints, these people back then, God was right there in their face and they still wondered, was he God? Uh-oh. He was right there doing miracles. He was helping people. He was showing people love, grace, and mercy. And people were still wondering, was he the true king? But you see, John let them know quickly that he was who? Jesus the Christ. Not comparing, to not trying to compare him to Jesus, but I tell you, he wants you to know, I baptize you with water, but there's one mightier than I. Amen. John said, don't try to sit up there and make me no king. Amen. Don't put me on a pedestal that I can't reach. Amen. And I tell you that today, don't put me on a pedestal that I can't reach. Amen. I'm not Jesus and I'm not God. Amen. I'm just a vessel used by God. Amen. And so what you come here for, you come here to praise the mighty name of Jesus. You come here to let the Lord know how grateful you are because he got you through the week. You come here to let God know that I thank you, Lord, for letting my light stay on when they told me my light was going to go off. You don't hear me today, saint. You see, John let them know real quick that, hey, don't put me on a place that I can't reach because I'm still man.
Yes,
I'm not even worthy of taking off his shoes or untying them. Amen. So John the Baptist is letting us know I'm not even worthy. Amen. If God came down here right now saying I would have to bow down.
Amen.
You ain't hear me today. Because it's not about me, it's about Jesus the Christ. It's not about who I am, amen. It's about who I work for, amen. It's about the one that I work for, the one that I stand strong for, the one I stand bold for, because I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus.
Hallelujah.
And so when you understand that this is not about me, that it's about God, then you start to see the power of God work in your life. Because God wants the people to understand that all I am just a workman in God's field.
Yes, that's it.
You see, saints, do we have the same reverence for Christ like we should? Knowing that he's coming back one day, I am grateful that he died for my sins so I can have a right to the tree of life.
Yes.
My. See, saints, I'm glad my soul jumps for joy. Jesus is alive. I can tell you today, he pulled me out of the muck and miry clay. Amen. Sinking deep in my sin, I was lost, but now I'm found. Amen. You see, saints, I was lost, but now I'm found through Jesus the Christ. I can't try to put this on myself. I can't put myself and be proud, because if it wasn't for Jesus, I would still be lost.
Yes.
You see, I can tell you that my Jesus reached back and grabbed my hand, set my feet on what? Solid ground. Oh, it was the blood that saved me. Nothing but the blood of Jesus. He was worthy to be praised, I tell you, because he is God and he's God all along.
Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus.
Now watch this, saint. Now watch this. Now, while I'm saying all this, Satan is still busy. Satan is the king of jealousy. He was jealous of Adam and of Jesus the Christ. He will kill, steal, and destroy weak Christians. Amen. Satan is also jealous of you, because now you're trying to follow the true king.
Yes.
And so Satan says, I can get you to mess up. Are you with me today? If I can get you to fall short. Amen. If I can get you to keep holding on to the pet sins, the things that you know that is wrong, but you're going to keep holding on to, you're going to keep doing what you want to do, Satan said, I got you. Are you with me today? He going to say, I got you, because I want to hurt God. I don't care about you. Amen. Satan don't care about you. He want to hurt God.
Yeah.
Amen. He said, God, I'm going to take your children and turn them against you. Amen. How many of us would be upset if somebody in the neighborhood would turn your kids against you? Y'all know that, yeah, trust me, saints, they whispering in the kids' ear and telling your dad ain't nothing. I seen your dad doing, I seen your mom doing this. And they turn your kids against you. Your kids start talking back to you. Your kids start getting smart. You gonna break that kid neck.
Right now.
Lord Jesus. So we got to understand. So that's Satan. Satan is trying to turn us against God.
Yeah.
Amen. He's trying to get us from the love of God. He's trying to get us from the safety. He said, if I can get you away from God, I can do what I want to you. Yeah. Ooh, Jesus, wow. Jesus. Wow. But see, Jesus. But Jesus.
What?
Amen. If Jesus is on your side, you cannot lose. Stand firm, and God will stand with you. Amen.
This is Open Door Radio, Dayton. Ladies, if you're looking for the total church outfit, visit Gilmart & Company Boutique, located at 2539 Shallow Springs Road, Trotwood, Ohio. The phone number is 937-854-7510. Open Monday through Saturday from 11 a.m. to 7 p.m. Gilmart specializes in keeping you queenly. So make your way over to 2539 Shallow Springs Road or look them up on Facebook. Gilmart & Company.
This is Open Door Radio, Dayton. I thought about three young men, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Amen. The king wanted them to bow down, but they said, are we not going to bow down to you, king? Amen. And so the king was upset. Why you not? Well, we got a king to bow. I'm not going to bow down to mere man. Amen. He said, I'm not going to bow down to you because you said bow down. I got a king that sits on high, but he looks down low. Are you with me today? You see, the three Hebrew boys took a stand with Christ. And they got, and the king was so upset that he said, well, I'm going to throw y'all in the fiery furnace.
Yes, that's what he
Are you with me?
I'm going to destroy you because you're not doing what I tell you to do. You see, so the king grew jealous within. Amen. Satan was all on that king. Yeah, destroy them, kill them, take them out. We have to seek knowledge, wisdom, and understanding of God. People, I tell you today, join church and carry jealousy with them right into the church. They are joining church and they got jealousy lagging right with them. Amen. But I tell you today, saint, that God is looking for some Christians that's going to stand strong and not waver.
Yes.
John 16 and 33 says, I have spoken unto you that in me ye might have peace, and in the world you shall have tribulations. Amen. So God is telling us right there that even though you're in the world, amen, I can give you peace, but tribulation gonna still come.
That's right.
See, that's when we get mixed up. We feel a lot of times once we know who Christ is that nothing's supposed to happen. But God never said once you follow me, nothing's gonna happen. He said once you follow me, you will have persecution.
That's what he said.
You will be tempted. There will be tribulation. There will be things, tests, trials, and tribulations that's going to come upon your life. Are you with me? So the text says, if you have Jesus, you should have peace in him. But I tell you, Satan can control a weak-minded Christian better than a seasonal Christian. Amen. There's some haters in this house, so don't be jealous because I know Jesus the Christ. Don't get mad because I know who God is. Don't get mad because I'm standing for God. Don't get mad because I go to church every Sunday. Don't get mad because I'm reading my Bible. Don't get mad because I'm praying. Amen. All you got to do is say, hey, he's a Christian because he's doing what the Lord told him to do.
Amen. Amen. Come on, preacher.
My brothers and sisters, let's take back our churches from the jealous people, the ones trying to hurt the church and keep us from growing. Amen. I'm here to let you know that we have power, saints, but we don't use our power because we let Satan cover our power from us. Now, Jesus said, if I be lifted up, I'll draw all men unto me. So spread the gospel to a dark and dying world today, saints. I tell you today, I can't tell you one day, but open door, I tell you, every knee shall bow, every tongue will confess that Jesus is Lord. What a great day that will be. I'm going to remember to help all sinners, amen, turn back to Christ. I wish I had two Christians here today that can say amen.
Amen.
I tell you today, St. Matthew 26 and 41 said, watch and pray so you will not fall into temptation. Watch and pray daily, saint, that the Spirit will help you stay away from jealous folks that mean you no good. There's no haters in this house, amen. There's some haters in this house, but I'm going to tell you there's no haters in my life, amen. Satan will beat you down with the hopelessness and jealousness, amen. He wants to see how far you can push you over the edge. He wants to see if he can push you over the edge. Amen. Don't push me because I'm too close to the edge. I'm trying not to what? Lose my head. Amen. I don't know if y'all know that song or not. Amen. But the thing is, God, Satan is trying to get us to the edge, so he want to push us off. Amen. But I tell you, as long as you got Christ in your life, you don't have to worry about that. Amen. I'm glad today, saints, because God is a good God. We were not always saved. The Lord is still working on me. I was not always saved, saint, but I tell you, when I found out who God is in my life, I started to work towards Jesus. Amen. I started to look towards Jesus. I started to walk towards Jesus. Amen. And when I started to walk towards Jesus, my life started to change. I said, Lord, thank you for creating me a clean heart. Amen. And so I thank God today because he's a good God.
Hallelujah.
We must get back on track with the Lord. Stop flirting with sin. The Lord will wait until it's time for you to meet him. And don't hate on me because what? I know Jesus. We have to believe like John, standing bold on what we believe, that one day Christ is coming back and we all gonna stand up against haters, amen, backstabbers and criminals. We will run from us because why? We know Jesus the Christ. Are you with me today? Saints, stand on the promises of Christ. Keep spreading the good news of Jesus because one day he's coming back for a church without a spot or a wrinkle. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. Who are you going to follow today? Satan or Jesus the Christ? Will you let jealous folks pull you away from Christ, or will you gravitate back to Christ. Amen. I'm going to stand until I can't stand no more. Love those that don't love you. Keep following God because he said, I'm going to take you where you need to go. I can tell you today, he's coming back. Don't let the time pass you by before you turn your life over to the Savior. Amen. Don't wait until the last minute, say, when Jesus cracked that sky, because it's going to be too late. One day, the one who died for the remission of sin, amen, I tell you, will never die again because he will never die again because he's coming back real soon. I'm glad you can't buy salvation today. Salvation is free. Jesus is my personal Savior. Amen. He set me free from all my sins. Let me hear someone say amen today, because he set you free. Amen. I'm glad he's the all-powerful. I'm glad that he knows what he's doing. Power that keeps on giving. Power to become one. Power to obey my parents. Power to be blessed. Power to have joy. Power to follow Jesus the Christ. Because they hung him high. They stretched him wide. He hung his head and then he died. But he didn't stay dead, saints, because early one Sunday morning, my God got up with all power in his hand, and I don't have to worry about this world because God is a good God. Saints, we don't have to worry about jealous people, haters, backstabbers, or even those that's coming up against us, because Jesus said he would never what? Leave us or forsake us. My God is a good God. He is the bright and morning star. He is the Alpha and the Omega. He is the first and the last. They call him the Great Counselor, Mighty God, Awesome King. Yeah. My brothers and sisters, I want to be ready on that great morning. Amen. Ready when he said, come my faithful servant and rest, because your labor is well done for your labor. Jesus is preparing us a place to stay. Amen. In the sky. Amen. And I'm glad today when I get back up there with Jesus, there's not going to be any pain and suffering, no strife, no jealousy, nothing up there but peace and harmony.
Hallelujah.
And I'm glad. And I'm going to walk around heaven all day, praising and worshiping my Lord every chance I get. Are you ready? Are you ready? Are you ready? Amen. And thank God. I don't have to worry about the jealous people, because I got a God that sits on high and looks down low. And I thank God today because he is my King.
You are listening to Open Door Radio Dayton with your host, Pastor Roberto V. Roche Sr. This is Open Door Radio, Dayton, 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 Dayton. If you're looking for a new kind of store, visit the Red Carpet Market, Emporium and Business Enterprises, which is now open at 4721 West 3rd Street at the Westtown Shopping Center next to the Essence Beauty Supply, Dayton, Ohio. Their phone number is 937-251-2701. They're looking for vendors and dealers. A unique community emporium. Rent a table, booth, or showcase. Learn, sell, and buy. Call today to reserve your space. 937-251-2701. You are listening to Open Door Radio Dayton with your host, Pastor Roberto V. Roche Sr.
God is truly good, and he is worthy to be praised. I need Jesus today.
You are listening to Open Door Radio Dayton with your host, Pastor Roberto V. Roche Sr.
You have been listening to the Open Door Radio Dayton with your host, Pastor Roberto V. Roche Sr., the pastor of Open Door Missionary Baptist Church, located at 4817 West 3rd Street, Dayton, Ohio, inside the Progressive Baptist Church building. Our weekly Our Power begins at 11:30 a.m. and our worship experience starts at 1 p.m. We would like to thank our sponsors today, Gil Martin Company Boutique and the Forever Ready Transportation and Home Health Care Agency. We would also like to thank the Red Carpet Market Emporium and Business Enterprises. This broadcast was produced by Open Door Media Relations and a Hood Style Way of Life. God bless.